So, hello everybody. I hope I turned on the mic. So, let's see what day 6 of Advent of Code gives us. So, memory reallocation. So 60 memory banks, memory bank holds blocks, and we have to balance the blocks. Memory bank with the most blocks. It removes all of the blocks, moves it to the next. What? So 0 2 7 0. Okay, so we take everything from the seven because it's the mo it has the most blocks. So two blocks, two blocks, two blocks, and one because I guess 7 divided by 3 is 2. Okay. Second bank, okay. I think I get it. Hello, cat. So let's see. Don't purr next to the mic. I'm sure people would appreciate it, but I have to write some code. So, okay. So the input is a list of integers. Output is an integer. How does it look? So it's tabs. So let's retab it. Almost. Okay, so to parse it, we'll have to split by spaces and make integers from them, so that should be all right. Let's just write the test. So and let's just keep empty test here. So, example failure compute. Okay, so our parse is working. So, So let's remember, the states we've been in, the current state, and how many cycles have we done. Maybe we do not have to do it. We could learn. We could take it from the length of the memory. Yeah, we probably don't need it. So. So, slight change of names. So it will give us again. List of integers. So now, that should work. So we are adding the new state to the memory. I should probably use a set. We will see if this is slow or not. So to redistribute, we have to find the maximum number. Okay. So, this should not happen. Because the list will always have something in it. So, there's the max number. Now, let's see. New maximum number is 'maximum number divided by probably modulo, because 7 modulo 3 is 1. So, okay, and let's just work with arrays again, because we have to do random access. Does array have length or size? length. So we have to write maximum ourselves. So let's just do what we did, but or maybe not. Fault. That could work, I guess. So input with new max is update input, no, set. Yeah, I have to know the index. So okay, that will be harder. At least array has index map, so index map, and now we have the indexes and let's see if it works. I'm never sure about the first the one from the list and then the accumulator. Okay, so what's wrong? Sure. Oop, I can't write today. Okay, what now? So okay, that works. Let's finish it. Okay, so let's write that. Oh man, leaderboard is already full. Wow. Also, hi Grisel. So now we have to do array and we get another array. I guess that already, why am I writing this? Why did I want to write it myself? So we did the max index and now we have to actually, wouldn't something like map probably be better? Oh, input array map index map. Index and a number. And now, if index is max index, then else n plus two others. So this redistribute and compute. So it does not know modulo. Oh, we probably have this one. I was writing something in Haskell yesterday and it probably stuck. So remember, why you no member? I'm lazy today, but that should work. Input process memory, process inputs memory. So the memory will be empty list. Yeah, sure. So this should not be a list. And oh yeah, sure. Why? I am slow today. Like, I don't mean like on the leaderboard, but like mentally. Array length memory. So that's also a list. And is Elm basically Haskell on JavaScript? Well, that's a description that probably more fits like pure script, but it's really similar. Yeah, it has similar syntax. It is less advanced, like it does not have, type classes and so on, but I think it has like the, least syntax for the most, I don't know, bang. Like it is easy to learn, like if you did not do functional programming, it's really fast to get into, and the guarantees it gives over JavaScript are great. So, easy refactoring, like nice compiler error messages and so on. So, yeah, basically, like if you squint a lot, then it's Haskell on JavaScript, but Haskell people would not like you to say that. Okay, so why did it? What? Oh yeah, I've done it. I should have done this. So these error messages are kinda not what you see in normal Elm development, because I am running on Node and doing like debug crash. So those are nodes, and those are nodes, and like this is what you should have seen. So I haven't seen it. 1331. So that's probably not right. So let's see. 0270. Do I test on that? 0270. So let's see. 0270 got changed into 1331, which is not right. So why does it not do much here? Yeah, okay, yeah, sure. I didn't compile. Max index is 2. It should. Okay, let's debug. New max and two others. So new max should not have been 3. New max should have been 1. Right. So what's the length? So the input 0 to 70, length is 4. All right, yeah, I have to. I should do this. Yeah, I think that's wrong. That's what was wrong. So 1, 1, 3, 4, 1. So let's see, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 3, 4, 1, 3, 4, 1, and then we've seen it. So we are off by one, which means we can just fix that here. So output 1 is 2. That would be fast. That's not the right answer. Yeah, I thought so. So what happens? We should take 14 and redistribute it. Okay, so let's put those back in. Yeah. It should be here, and so we are starting here. So 14, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so index is good, and now add to others 0. So, okay, what should have happened? And oh, it inserts one of the blocks. Okay, yeah, so we are doing it wrong. So we should not. I really don't want like to loop on the array and do that stuff. I should be able to calculate it, but So let's see. My problem is that I want to give everybody like the new count in one go. And if there's less to give, then there's the number of the banks, then nobody gets anything. So let's put that back. So while loops is zero. So let's see. If is zero, then we'll have to like give only some of those one block, which means okay, I think it'll be easier to just recurse on that. So so the maximum I think does not need the index anymore. I am still on part one here. So, what this will do is so to give and index array set index I would like update function, but it probably is not here. Okay, so let's write one because I don't want to do map with index every time. Update index, and we have index here. Update index, so we have the old element and we have to do this advent of code 2017? Yeah, it is. this should work. So new array is array with update index x plus 1. Yeah, that's everything. If to give is greater than 0, and if index then we'll do this. And so now let's just do, if we don't have anything to give, then we just return array. That should work. Woo! So it is already working on the problem. So the test passed, I guess. And it's slow. So we should be able to optimize this a bit. So let's see. The whole loops. Whole loops is oh wait, does it still, it's it's not working on the input, it's working on the, yeah, on the old stuff. So what was wrong here is we have to start at the number after the maximum. So my bad. And now it would be great if I didn't, you know, delete my code before. Minus one, minus one. So index number, maximum index, maximum number. Now maximum again. Okay. So what's happening? Oh, we want to give. If we give 0, does it end there? Oh, and the 7 never got lost there. So redistribute. Without max is input array set max index 0. Okay, so it's trying the new stuff. That probably means the old stuff works. Tests passed. Okay. So let's see if it's any fast. Get So let's try to optimize on the memory level. So set of oops. So set has a size and a member. Okay. Oh, it stopped. Okay, that's the right answer. So we didn't even have time to optimize. Size of the loop. How many block cycles must be performed? How many cycles? 2, 4, 1, 2. Is seen again after 4 cycles. I don't understand it. How many redistributions? And now, how many cycles? Starting from 2, 4, 1, 2. What is the length of infinite loop? But isn't it asking the same thing? Like maybe minus one or something. How many cycles? Oh wait. No. 2, 4, 1, 2 is seen again after 4 cycles. Oh yeah, sure. So this is before we got into the loop, and this is the actual loop. So okay, so we have to keep the list because the order will be important. And now let's see process. So I will have process 2, which will be almost the same. And if it sees something, it will give me what? So we know the new state is in there somewhere. So we have to get the index of the new state in there minus something something, I think. So memory is index. So this is the index. And index would be this. So this might be very naive, but I think that will work. And it should give us 4. And let's not do anything in the first program because I don't want to wait for it. So 5. Okay, start. List head, maybe map, tuple first, maybe with default minus 1. Okay, again. Actuals 2. So what was wrong here? Debug new state. Memory. Oh right, I'm adding to the front. So actually, I don't know if we start with 0270 and it's not there. Zero two seven zero two four one two. We'll see. So what was it? 7000. So we should get our answer after 7000, probably. Yeah, you can see it's slowing down. Poor thing. So let's see. 1695. Great. I was starting to get really nervous about this whole thing because it was just like a guess at how that could work, and I wasn't really sure if the reversing the list is gonna help me, but it did. Come on. So I'm glad that worked. So let's clean that up. And yeah, we should probably put that and commit. Yeah, so that was really puzzling for me, like I had to read like the second part multiple times before I understood like what do they want from me. But in the end we did it, so thanks one red boy. Okay, great. So let's just see how fast did the people do it. 3 minutes to get both, 2 minutes to get the first one. Yeah. Well, 2 minutes is really impressive. Like, these guys are really good. And using imperative language, like Python, probably helps a lot. Great, so finished. Yay! Yeah, he is a monster. I think he wrote on the Reddit, like, what does he do? Like, he is, you know, some functions ready and he, like, he doesn't, like, slow himself with the tests. He just, like, writes it on the input. Yeah. Okay, so thanks for watching and let's see you tomorrow.